Welcome back to another episode of In Totality. I am your host, Megan Ashley, and I am thrilled that you came back to kick it with us. If you did not know, today is officially our 1 year anniversary. So virtual claps all the way around. We are so excited that we've made it a year. It seems as if the year has flown by. And it has. I think that, you know, if I think on month by month, it feels like there were some moments that were like drawn out and dragged out, but we've made it a year. And what I can be most grateful for, what I am most grateful for, is that the Lord has been with us, and that the Lord has provided, that the Lord has been, you know, sustaining us, that he has kept us. And then for me to look and see, you know, Jay and Jordan are still here sitting behind the cameras doing all the things, like, I'm grateful for that, that the Lord has really like sustained us. And so I'm going to try my best not to get emotional, because yeah, it just was a hard year. And so, you know, to have people still be by your side, it's just, I'm just super grateful, and I'm grateful that the Lord has sustained us and provided in like in multiple ways, like financially provided and made sure that everybody was taken care of, provided, you know, equipment and my home and just all the things that like you can easily take for granted or easily forget to thank him for. I'm just grateful. And so, yeah, before we get started with the episode, make sure you click the subscribe button. Make sure you hit the like button. Make sure you, do all the things. It was funny because I was looking at the episode, my first episode. Oh, thanks. Jordan's like, here's some tissue. Are you okay? Yada, yada, whatever. But it was funny because I was looking at the first episode that we did and like how I was like literally 20 pounds smaller. Like I look sick and we were in my basement and I just remember being so scared. Like I was so scared to do this, you know, to do the podcast. And, I was just listening to it this morning as I was getting ready. And one thing that I'm grateful for is that a lot of the things that God has shown me and a lot of the things that he spoke to me when starting this podcast has remained, like being completely dependent on him has been like a theme, I guess, for this year. And so, yeah, just taking myself back to that day, that episode, how, you know, how I was in a place of healing, still a lot of brokenness in me, but healing, and how fearful I was, but that I did it, how as much as the enemy wanted me to feel alone, how I could look and see that Jay and Jordan were there, and how she, like, they're still here. So all the things, I'm just, like, super, super grateful. And so, yeah, my Patreon community, I let them know that we were doing a one-year anniversary episode. And I really don't have much to say because, as you guys know, I'm still reeling from Acts 2:42 conference. I'm still in utter shock and awe at what God did. I mean, I'm not shocked in the sense of it's God, right? But, like, I'm still in awe of what happened this past weekend at the Acts 2:42 conference. And so, yeah, this episode is going to be super laid back. I'm just going to answer some of the questions from my Patreon community as far as like what this year has been like. And kind of maybe some of the lessons I've learned, some of the transitions that I've made, all the things. And so if you would like to join my Patreon community, the link is going to be in the description. You can go to www.patreon.com/MeganAshley and join there. You'll get all the behind the scenes of kind of my life. We have a docuseries that Jay so brilliantly produces and does all the things for that. And it really is like this, you know, vantage point of just all the other stuff that you don't get to see. Stuff like my children, preparing for certain speaking engagements, life, just life stuff at the house, or just doing things with my kids, doing stuff with Jay and Jordan. You get to see my mom and some of my other family members, some friends. And so it's really cool to kind of see, like, when, again, when I said in totality, I meant that. I don't believe that. I think with wisdom, it's good for leaders to show how they steward their lives. And so I want to be a part of showing you that you can, you know, you can actually do this thing. You can actually sustain it and not compromise. And yeah, just being transparent and vulnerable. That's just kind of all of what I'm about. And so the docuseries, you get to see that. You have some bonus clips from some guests that I've had on the podcast. We do Bible studies. We do book clubs. All of this is on Patreon. And it really is, more than anything, Patreon, the village, has been a community of people. Like, they love each other. They have really, people have found their people in the village. Like, best friends have found best friends. Yeah, it's just a beautiful, it's a beautiful community. And so if you're looking to kind of fellowship with like-minded believers, I highly encourage you to join Patreon. And so, yeah, we have some really exciting things coming on there. Even like, I'm really excited because I don't know what Jay's been doing for like all the stuff for Acts, but I'm really excited to see all the behind the scenes stuff that happened that weekend. I mean, Jay was everywhere, and he caught some really cool moments that everyone isn't gonna see, but you will see it on Patreon. So I'm really excited about that. What else? Am I forgetting some? YouTube, yeah, subscribe, like, all the things, share, listen on all audio platforms. That still really helps. I know you probably like just watching the YouTube, but listening to the audio platforms really helps. Oh, Acts 242 has a YouTube page, guys, where you, if you're looking to like see all the stuff that happened. I know a lot of people were bummed out that they couldn't come, but you get to experience some of the glory that we experience. You'll be able to see that on YouTube. So make sure you subscribe to that as well. All right, well, I'm going to get into some questions that my Patreon community has asked me. Jordan's going to help me out. Okay, so the question is, how have the boys responded to the success of the pods? And do I include them in, like, with guests and topics and stuff? I think for Caleb, I feel like he's completely, like, unaware of, I mean, he's aware but doesn't, like, have a response to the podcast. I think Jonah is extremely curious. He's kind of like, what is this? So what's happening? Like, what do you really do? Like, I think he's just extremely curious of what it is that I do all the time. Like, if I, you know, he knows that, like, this is all about Christ. He knows, like, the mission. I just think that he's curious of, like, what it all means. Like, you know. So when he has friends that say, like, what does your mom do? He's like, she has a podcast. She talks about Jesus. She travels sometime and talks. So I think he's just curious. I think Eli is my oldest, and he's extremely just proud. I think I think he's the one who's experienced me the most. And so he's aware of some of the transit, you know, the intensity of the transitions that I've been in. And so for him to see me persevere and keep going and, you know, make my life about what God is doing in me and through me and what God has done just in general, I think he's just very proud. like, yeah, like my mom has been through a lot and she's continued to persevere. And I think he thinks it's cool. Like, you know, he's a teenager, so he'll see videos and on TikTok and stuff like that. I think for Eli, the most I get, or Eli and Jonah, I get a little concerned with because they are on TikTok. They're not on TikTok, but Eli has a TikTok. Jonah doesn't, but I don't know. I think sometimes he still gets on there. But anyway, I think with them having access to social media, I've been kind of, you know, more concerned with, you know, what they might see and how that might make them feel when people don't have the nicest things to say about me. All right, guys, before we continue with this episode, I want you to meet my new friend, Bioma. The first symbiotic of its kind, a revolutionary blend of prebiotics, probiotics, and postbiotics, all combined in a single capsule to help you feel your best. Bioma isn't just another supplement. It's a scientifically backed formula designed to support digestion, boost energy, and even enhance skin health. Plus, with the powerful ingredients tributyrin and a smart delayed release capsule, Bioma goes straight to where it matters the most, your gut. Sound familiar? Bloating, low energy, cravings you can't shake? These daily struggles are real, and you're definitely not alone. Bioma has helped thousands of people and especially popular among menopausal women for everything from hot flashes, mood swings, brain fog, weight management. So how does it work? Bioma's unique symbiotic formula restores health bacteria in your gut, giving your body what it needs to feel lighter and more energized. You'll start noticing benefits like clear skin, less bloating, and more balanced weight, all from bringing harmony back to your gut. People start Bioma because they want to feel better in their day-to-day, and it's been a game changer. Less bloating, more energy. It's incredible. And by judging from all the positive reviews, you are definitely not going to be alone in noticing the difference. Ready to feel the Bioma difference? Head over to bioma.health/totality and use totality for an exclusive 10% discount. Don't wait to take control of your gut health. Experience the benefits for yourself. All right, guys, back to the show. You know, and so as the podcast has expanded, as the platform grows, I'm becoming more, you know, aware that they could see things and I'm just wanting to protect them. And so it's causing me to have to shift, like, and not be so naive and be like, oh, it's not that big of a deal. But it's like, yeah, I want to protect them in a lot of ways. Yeah, I think they're proud of their mom. I think they're proud of how we've continued to do this. Yeah, I don't think I have any other thing to say other than that. Like, they're just really proud. And I'm grateful that I have children who are excited that I get to, you know, spread the gospel and help people know more about God. I think that's really cool. So this question from one of my amazing village members, it says, my question is, what was the hardest part of starting In Totality for you a year ago? And what is now your favorite part of having In Totality podcast a year later? I think the hardest part of starting was doing a podcast alone. I think that was like a major insecurity of mine, is like, I was like, oh dang, like I have to do this by myself and carry this by myself in a sense. I think that was really scary for me. It was really hard to know how to be vulnerable and transparent with wisdom, right? Like, it's real easy to get in front of the mic and just say whatever, but I do take the responsibility, like I hold influence, I take that responsibility seriously. Like, I take that serious, and I don't wanna ever misuse what God has entrusted me with by just saying how I feel, what, and not caring about the effects of that. So I think I wanted to be very transparent and honest, but also use wisdom where I'm not damaging, you know, anybody in the process or dishonoring anyone in the process. I really wanted to focus, not centering myself, centering Christ, but then using what God is teaching me, just using myself as an example of what God is doing and what he has done in me and who he is without pointing the fingers at other people or any of that. So I think that that was challenging for me, because I can be very transparent in a naive way, thinking that everyone can hear my heart or, you know, everyone understands or whatever the case may be. I think that was hard. What I love about In Totality now, I love that it gives people the opportunity to feel heard. Like, I'm not this super polished person. I'm extremely sensitive and emotional and all the things. And so I think In Totality gives people this feeling where it's like I'm talking to a friend, or I'm listening to a friend, or I'm listening to like my homegirl, and you know, they can just feel relaxed. Like, we're having a normal conversation, that the conversation isn't above them, that they don't have to come in feeling like, oh, I'm so unintelligent, or, you know, I can't understand, you know, I feel like I try to do my best at presenting the things of God and the gospel in a way where it is very, you know, digestible, like it's easy to hear. And so I'm really happy about what God has done in the podcast in that sense. I really enjoy having conversations with people that I admire. Like, I've had some of my favorite people on the podcast, and that has been really cool. So yeah, I think those are the things that I love about it. I love the fact that I get to do it at my house. Like, I love the fact that I don't have to go anywhere, that I can literally go from my bedroom to the living room or my dining room and sit and talk. Like, I love that my children get to be in the house and see what's going on. Yeah, I just think that it's a really cool thing to do, and it's hard, but I love what it opens up for people. I love the conversations that it opens up for people. I love that I'm able to use my platform to present new books, new people, new conversations, new ideas, all the things. So yeah, those are things I really, really love about it. Another question. This is from Jasmine. Hey Meg, because you take the Lord serious and you take responsibility serious, how do you handle the responsibility that God has given you and the lives you've changed and the weight of the work you do and the Lord speaking through you? Yeah, I think taking God serious is, to me, it's like my only response, because I feel like he took me very serious. I feel like the Lord did all, like, he never stopped pursuing me. Like, he loved me so much that when I wasn't thinking about him, when I wasn't pursuing him, when I wasn't considering him, he still pursued me. He still like found me in my brokenness and came to me and loved me and encouraged me and provided for me when I wasn't checking for him. And so that type of love, I feel like I am supposed to do all that I can do to make, you know, to honor that, you know. It feels like a weight, but it's not a weight that I have to carry alone. And it's not a weight where I'm fully responsible for it, right? It's a weight that I have to give to the Lord. It's a weight that I allow him to carry, that I allow him to help me with. I'm not, you know what I'm saying? Like, I'm not doing this all on my own. The Lord has provided many of resources, many of people to help me carry this. So it's not that I'm carrying it on my own, but the weight of it does require a level of dependency that I have to have on him. And so because I take it serious, I don't ever approach this microphone without praying. I never approach this microphone just whatever, let's just get on the mic and talk about anything. I'm always asking the Lord, like, Holy Spirit, fill me, fill my mouth with your words. Let me say something that will impact people to love you more, to know you more, to consider you more, all the things. Like, so yeah, it's like there is a responsibility I have. There is a weight that it comes with. But it's something that it causes me to be 100% dependent on the Lord to carry it and to do, and to not center myself, but to center him in it and allow him and his grace to carry me so that I can do whatever it is that he's calling me to do or say whatever it is that he's calling me to say. And I just believe, like, even in the times that we're living in right now, like, I believe that times are sensitive. I believe that time is running out. I believe that we're going into darker times. And so if I can sit on this mic and, you know, promote repentance, to promote God's word, to promote a relationship with him, to promote dependency on him, to promote, you know, a relationship where you take him serious, where you literally give your life as a living sacrifice. If that's what I can do, if that's my part, then I want to do that, because I don't want to see anyone perish. You know what I'm saying? Like, I want to see people come into a full knowledge and relationship with the Lord. I really do. And I'm not perfect at it. I'm still figuring things out even a year later of doing this podcast. But that is where my heart is to say, hey, listen, at the end of the day, you have to give the Lord your life in totality. Like, you have to give him all of you. And so, yeah, that's just, that weight doesn't always feel good, but it's a weight that if I do not rely on the Lord, it will crush me, period. It's a weight that if I try to center myself into it, it'll crush me. It's a weight that if I make it about me, it will destroy me. And so I'm constantly casting my cares on the Lord. I'm constantly asking the Lord to help me. I'm constantly asking the Holy Spirit to fill me. I'm constantly relying on the Lord to carry what he has entrusted me to carry. But I also reminding myself that it is not mine. You know what I mean? In totality isn't mine. That's the Lord's. This podcast isn't mine. It's the Lord's. You know what I mean? And so, yeah, I think just keeping that constant mind frame and making my intimacy with the Lord a priority. You know what I'm saying? Not taking weeks away or days away from not praying or spending time in his word or making this ministry my relationship with the Lord. All right, guys, before we continue on with this episode, I want to talk to you about a topic that I love. Laundry is a ritual we all do. Our next sponsor has made the ritual of laundry day so much better. This podcast is sponsored by Laundry Sauce. Laundry Sauce created the world's best smelling laundry detergent in simple to use, high performance pods. Laundry Sauce has transformed doing laundry into a luxury and exciting experience, so you don't have to dread laundry day anymore. So what's the secret sauce behind Laundry Sauce? They partnered with one of the top fragrance houses in the world, the same team behind many of your favorite designer scents, from Australian sandalwood to Egyptian rose to Siberian pine. Laundry day will never smell the same again. I just used the Egyptian rose pods and my clothes smell amazing. Laundry Sauce has some of the most authentic reviews you'll ever read. Like Tim describing Laundry Sauce as, it's like being transported to a land of bliss. You guys, listen, it's not just the pods. Laundry Sauce makes scent boosters, dryer sheets, dryer balls, fabric softeners, and even candles. Plus, if you aren't happy, send back Laundry Sauce for a full refund, no questions asked. Now it's time to elevate your laundry ritual with Laundry Sauce. Head over to laundrysauce.com/totality and use promo code TOTALITY to check out 15% off. That's the best offer you'll find, but you must use my code TOTALITY for 15% off your order. One last time, that's laundrysauce.com/totality. Use promo code TOTALITY for 15% off. You know what I mean? I don't make In Totality my relationship with the Lord. My relationship with the Lord makes In Totality. And so just focusing on that and making Christ the center is really just the thing, truly. Oh, this is from Taylor Brooks. Hi, Megan. Thank you for your guest. Seeing how God has been working through you has truly been life-changing. My question is, what has been the biggest surprise for you over the past year? I think the biggest surprise of In Totality has been the reach that it has made. Like, I think that's the biggest surprise to me. Like, my mom's nail tech watches In Totality. That's just, like, random to me. Or, like, when... my ex-husband had a work person come in from out of town, and she watches In Totality. Like, it's just random people that I would just never have thought would watch it or know about it. I think that's just the biggest surprise to me, is the reach that it's had. I'm always taken aback about the reach that In Totality has had. So that's been the biggest surprise. This is from another Jasmine. Megan, what have you found to be the most beneficial and strengthening practices that have helped you as you walk, out your faith? And how did you know that your relationship with God was becoming more intimate? What has been the most beneficial and strengthening practices has been God's word and prayer. Those have been the biggest things, like making time to be silent with the Lord, like praying, being in his word, and then taking time to just be quiet and waiting and allowing him to, you know, speak to your heart, allowing him to, you know, yeah, I just think those are the biggest things, like reading God's word, praying first, seeking the Lord, developing that intimacy, cultivating that intimacy, reading his word so that I can know him better, so that I know his word, I know his commands, I know his ways, I know his nature, I'm filling myself up with who he is, and then just, you know, sitting with him where I'm not distracting myself with other things, but I'm just kind of sitting and soaking in his presence. I think those are the biggest things that have been helpful in my relationship with the Lord. And then surrounding myself with healthy community. Like, I think my community has been such a huge part of my growth, and it's such a huge part of my development, and allowing me to sustain and steward well what God has given me. So prayer, God's word, sitting with him and just being quiet and patient and waiting on the Lord, and then community and like surrounding myself with godly people who love the Lord and who can also hold me accountable, tell me when I'm wrong, tell me when I'm doing right, tell me how I can be better, encouraging me, all the things. So those are the ways. This is from y'all. Okay, if y'all are in my village community, y'all know I struggle so bad with people's names, but this is Tashika. I hope I said that right. Have you seen lives changed around you, family, friends who you know were in the world, and because of your lifestyle change have had submission to God? They are now curious. How do you steward that? Where do you start? I think the biggest examples that I've seen is obviously Jay and Jordan. Like, when we started the podcast, or before we even started the podcast, when we started this journey of kind of wanting to know the Lord more, we started with reading The Bait of Satan. And Jordan and I started reading it. And then Jay was like, what y'all doing? And he started reading it too. And then I don't even know how, but Jay ended up surpassing us in the books because he's like a reading genius or something. I don't know. He just reads books really fast. So he's reading the book with us, and we just would sit in my office, and we would talk about what we read, and we would talk about what the Lord was doing in our hearts for hours. Like, we called my little office in the back, we call it the Hut headquarters, and we would meet in there, and we would just talk and talk and talk about what God was doing, about what he was showing us. And I think if you guys go back and watch the episode that I did with Jay and Jordan, I mean that to this day, like watching them love the Lord, watching them develop, watching how their language has changed, to see it in front of you, because we all live together, so we're like always around each other. It has been the most rewarding thing that I've ever experienced, to like see that happening in front of my eyes, like to see people change in their responses change. Like Jordan, to watch her pray at any given moment, like how that is her first response now, that if something happens, she, like, if she's feeling a way or whatever, that she silences herself and goes and prays. Like, you know what I mean? I just think watching people grow in front of your eyes is just the most beautiful thing that I've ever witnessed. And that's one thing that I'm so grateful for over the past year, seeing that. I think I've seen a change in, like, my kids in certain ways, especially Jonah. Like, I've seen a lot of changes in him over the last year. And I think it's because of how I was changing and how I was responding to things. My friend, like, y'all know I love my friend Ashley. She's one of my best friends. And even just her curiosity to the things of God has changed, and she's opened herself up in ways that I didn't really expect her to ever open herself up to over the last year. And I just think that it's because of the purity and the pursuit that I believe, you know, Jay Jordan and I have had over the last year and a half of just really purely seeking the Lord. And that's what happens. Like, we talk about the woman at the well, like, when she met Christ, she could not stop talking about it. And that's what happens. It's like when you truly meet him for real and you truly know him for real and you truly have a relationship with him for real, not the idea of a God that you've made up in your mind, like the one of the Bible that you know, that you have a relationship with, that you know his word and you know his commands and you follow it and you cultivate intimacy with him and you're praying and you're fasting and you're seeking and all the things. When you meet him in that way, you just can't help but talk about it. And the purity in that, I think, causes people to be curious. And it causes people to want to be like, I want to know about the God you say you serve. I want to know about the God that changed your life, because you used to do this and now you don't do that no more. And I can see that something in you has changed in a pure way. I'm curious about that. And I just think there have been so many examples in all of our lives where I have seen that that has happened. And so, I just think that that's dope. I think that's real dope. Okay, last one. How did you know to pursue in totality? How do you consider God when creating? Sometimes it feels hard to know whether to make a move without confirmation or keep moving until you do. How I knew to pursue in totality as far as the podcast, I believe that when I prayed, when I knew the last podcast was going to be over, and when it was done, I sincerely prayed and asked the Lord what he wanted me to do next, because I was totally fine with not podcasting. I was totally fine to, like, go back to, like, a kind of normal life, do a regular 9-to-5 and just do things that way. And I just remember asking the Lord, what do you want me to do? What do you want me to do? And at first I felt like I didn't get really a response. And then after some time, I felt like the Lord said, continue. And I remember my mom used to tell me that if you don't know what the Lord wants you to do next, do the last thing he told you to do and just keep doing it until he tells you to do something different. And so that was kind of like my confirmation for me to continue to do podcasting, because I felt like the Lord had really put a desire in my heart to share certain things. And it was a desire that I didn't have from my own flesh, but it was a desire I believe that he gave me. And so by listening to that, praying and seeking the Lord, and then having healthy community around me to say, hey, listen, I sense that the Lord wants you to continue to do this, or to help guide me and pray with me and intercede on my behalf, all the things to get me to the right answer. So community was really big. Obviously prayer was really big. And then again, like, I know that I did not feel at peace with stopping. As much as I was scared, as much as I didn't want to, I didn't have any peace about not continuing. And so, yeah, those were the things that kind of really promoted the courage to keep going. The second part of that question, let's see. When creating something, sometimes it feels hard to know whether to move without confirmation or to keep going. Yeah, I think that that's something that I've struggled with too, is like, you know what? It was really the sign, that sermon that Pastor Phil did. Remember when he was talking about the sign of Jonah, when he kept saying, stop looking for a sign, stop looking for, you know, these like mystical signs. I think that that was my thing too. I was always looking for confirmation in certain type of ways, instead of just reading God's word and having that be confirmation in and of itself. And so even in the most practical way, what does the Lord call you to do? Obey his commandments, love him, love your neighbor, make disciples, spread the gospel, right? So when I look at that and I align that with what I have a urge and a passion and desire to do in my heart, if those things align, then it's safe to say that you can kind of move in that direction, right? And so, yeah, that would just be my encouragement, is that if you're doing what the Lord calls you to do, when it says make disciples, spread the gospel, love him, obey him, you know, love your neighbor, all of those things, if that is in alignment with what you feel the Lord is calling you to do, then do it. You know what I mean? Do it with wisdom, have community around you to say, hey, I'm sensing the Lord is wanting me to do this. What do you think? Can you pray with me? Can we, you know, get together and talk about this? Like, community is obviously very important as well. I don't think you should just go rogue and do whatever you want. I think you should have community to help you. And then peace, you know what I mean? Like, really being mindful of peace, like that deep peace within you where you feel you're settled, not where you feel comfortable so much, because there have been things that the Lord has asked me to do that I have been uncomfortable doing, that I have been scared doing, but I've also had peace doing it. And so being mindful of that as well. Yeah, and just, you know, be sensitive to how the Holy Spirit is moving you. If he's telling you to move, then move. If he's telling you to wait, then wait. I think a lot of times we live in a hustle culture. So it's like, go, 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 go. When sometimes the Lord might be saying, wait. Be patient. Maybe you need to sit here for a minute and wait on the Lord to confirm and say things in you. So, yeah.
All right, guys, listen, every year we pledge to save more and spend less, but how are we supposed to save when we are paying inflated prices for everyday essentials like gas and groceries? You can't just cut those purchases out of your budget, but now, thanks to my 2024 money back hack, you can get cash back with them with Upside. Upside is an incredible app for anyone who buys gas, groceries, or dines out. With Upside, I get cash back on every purchase. It's my secret weapon for staying on track with my savings goals. You guys, listen, Upside offsets inflated prices by giving you cash back on every purchase. I use Upside when I'm filling up at the gas station, and who doesn't want to save money there? Listen, you can save money, buy an extra little Chick-fil-A sandwich, all the things. To get started, download the free Upside app, use my promo code TOTALITY, and get an extra 25 cents back for every gallon on your first tank of gas. Next, claim your offer for whatever you're buying on Upside, then pay as usual with a credit or debit card following the steps in the app and get paid. In comparison to credit card rewards or loyalty programs, you can earn 3 times more cash back with Upside. Plus, Upside doesn't sell your personal information to third parties. They know that your information is a vital part to their trusted relationship with you. Upside users are earning hundreds of dollars a year. That's probably why they have a 4.8 star rating on the App Store. Download the free Upside app and use promo code TOTALITY to get an extra 25 cents back for every gallon on your first tank of gas. That's an extra 25 cents back for every gallon on your first tank of gas using promo code TOTALITY. All right, guys, back to the show.
I hope that helps. I don't have any more questions. But I did want to answer this would you rather that I saw somebody on Patreon ask, and I thought it was really cute. So I think her name is Kaya, And so she said, would you rather travel or read books? I would definitely rather travel, but I would also like to travel and read. But if I had to pick, I would love to travel. Who would you rather have on your team, David or Daniel? I'm going to say David because I feel like I just love David. Yeah, I feel like I relate to David, so I love David. Sunday brunch or potluck after service? Dang. Probably, if I'm going to be honest, I'm going to probably say potluck only because I like coming home after church, like changing my clothes and just like chilling, like being on the couch. So a potluck after church would be where I go to. Hymns or worship music, both, I can't pick. Choose your leader, Joseph or Moses? This was hard. I'm going to say Moses, though, because brother went through the most. Like, Moses went through the most. Yeah, he went through the most. So I'm going to say Moses. He did his thing. If you can only read one of Paul's books for the rest of your life, Romans or Acts? So Paul didn't write Acts. Luke did. I love all of Paul's letters, to be honest with you. I think Romans and Ephesians are probably my two favorite of his letters. But I do love the book of Acts, even though Luke wrote the book of Acts. I love the book of Acts because it shows such this amazing blueprint of the early church. And I think it gives us a very practical way of how we should live. Like, I don't think it's too extreme. I can be kind of an extremist and like serious. So the book of Acts just speaks to me in that way. But yeah, I like those little, this or that, or would you rathers. Those are cool. So yeah, I just wanted to kind of answer some questions on what this last year has been like. Again, I'm so grateful for 52 weeks of episodes, for 52 weeks of conversations, 52 weeks of transparency and vulnerability. I don't know how many guests that we've had, but I just want to thank every single guest that I have had that has been on the podcast, people who I have looked up to, people who I admire, people that I love, I pray for, care about. So I'm so thankful for every single guest that has been on the platform, for people who have come alongside me and just encouraged me. And, yeah, I just think that it's been a crazy, wild ride, but I am so thankful for what the Lord has done. And I don't know what's going to happen next. I don't know what the next year is going to look like. I didn't know what this year looked like, but I am committed to being faithful to the Lord and doing all that he's called me to do, whether I'm scared, whether I feel qualified, whether I feel, equipped or whatever. I'm just going to do it and do whatever he calls me to do and trust in him in all of my ways, like really trusting in him and trusting what he's entrusted me with. And I pray that this podcast bless you. I pray that in one of the episodes that your life has changed, that your perspective might have changed, that you've considered the Lord more, that you're interested in who he is, not just in this mystical like fantasy way, but like the God of the Bible, like knowing your word. I'm just really grateful. This year has been transformative. Somebody asked, and one of my Patreon village members asked, like, if you had to sum up this year in one word, what would it be? And I don't know if I have one word, but I do know that it's been utter surrenderance. Like, I've been completely dependent on the Lord in everything. And I think that that's going to continue to be a theme, is that I'm going to have to continue to trust him, continue to depend on him, continue to lean on him. And we'll see where this takes us. I'm really excited for a break that I might be having coming up where, you may not get In Totality episodes, but just giving everyone time to rest and all the things. But then when I do come back, that I'll come back fresh and filled and, you know, with maybe a new perspective and some new things that the Lord is doing in me and has done in me. So I mean, I'm excited for that. Yeah, I'm grateful again for Jay and Jordan, who have been my support and, you know, my people. I'm grateful for, yeah, my mom, my kids, my support system, my community, for helping me, for being there for me. I'm so appreciative of the village. Like, y'all have no idea how much I love you guys, how much y'all mean to me, how much I pray for y'all. Like, y'all are the best supporters ever. And so shout out to every single person that's in the village community. We love you guys. We go hard for y'all. We rock with y'all. Like, y'all showed up this past weekend. I was just, I just cannot thank y'all enough for how you've supported me over the last year. It's just another example of God's kindness that he's been able to show me through the village community. And so I'm just excited for how we can continue to have discipleship and all the things in the next coming year. And so, and for all of you who watch on YouTube and listen to the audio and who listen, you know, week after week, I'm just so grateful. And I pray again that the Lord has met you in one of these episodes, that he's touched your heart in one of these conversations. And I pray that we can continue to grow together. Thank you for being patient with me. Thank you for enduring some of my imperfections and the ways where I've come up short, but just allowing me to really develop, you know, because that's hard to do in the public. It's hard to develop in the public. But you guys have been gracious, and I'm just thankful for all of you. So, journal prompt. I'm going to make it simple. Like, what has God done in you in the last year? What has changed? What have you learned about yourself? What have you learned about God? What have you seen different in your life in the last 52 weeks? And so that's your journal prompt for this week. And, you know, hopefully in the coming up of 52 weeks, I won't forget to do the journal prompt. I'll remember to do those. Thank you, Jay, for always reminding me. And that's your journal prompt. What has God done in your life in the last year? What has he shown you? What has he changed? What have you learned about him? Those are your journal prompts. And I will see you guys next week.